Odds are that if you work with Flutter, eventually you'll have to handle files and directories. Let's do a quick summary of all the basic file system operations that we can do with Flutter. By using the Path Provider plugin, we can get the path to common directories designed for different purposes. For instance, we will use get temporary directory for cache files. Get application support directory will give us a path to put files that shouldn't be exposed to the user, while get application documents directory will point to a path to store user-generated files. These are just some examples of paths that Path Provider gives us. Let's create a random file in the temporary directory and write something inside. First, we get the temporary directory. Then, we create a file object with the path of the temporary directory and the name of the file. Finally, we write some sample content within the file with the writeAsString method. The delete method is just as crucial as the create method, as it helps clear out all files and thus saves valuable storage space. Now, let's say that I want to create a new file, but within a certain directory. We can achieve it by using the directory class. We first check that this directory exists, and if it doesn't, then we create it before creating a new file inside. Now, let's do the reverse and delete the directory. Sometimes you need to list all files within a directory to get some of its stats. You can achieve this with the listSync method. You can use the readAsString method to open a file to see its content. Now, let's generate a duplicate of the previously created sample file using the copy function. Next, let's change the name of the file we just copied with rename. So far, I've demonstrated how to handle files asynchronously, which is the preferred method. However, if for some reason futures are an option for you, synchronous file operations are also possible. For instance, here's a sample of how to write a file synchronously. All file system operations should be performed safely since they are prone to throw exceptions. For simplicity, the previous examples did not include this, but it's critical to always encapsulate your I/O operations within a try-catch block. Dart and Flutter simplify working with files, as demonstrated before. I hope this summary was useful and clear. If it was, please click that like button and subscribe to the channel for more Flutter content. And if you want to learn how to use the repository pattern combined with clean architecture to build a clean and performant app, check out this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a nice rest of your day. Goodbye.